Are you struggling with SSL certificates, custom domains, or reverse proxy configuration? Today, we'll walk through Traefik and show you how it automates routing and security for our Docker Compose stack. Hey everyone, welcome back to Tendevin Tech and our server security series. In the last video, we set up Portainer to manage our Docker containers. If you missed that one, hit the card above or click the link in the description to catch up. I've created a GitHub repository with all the files you need for this tutorial, including the Docker Compose file and configuration files we'll be working with today. The link is in the description below. Today, we're focusing on Traefik, a dynamic reverse proxy and load balancer for Docker. We'll cover what Traefik is and why it's essential for our stack, how to set up Traefik with Docker Compose, how to configure Traefik, how to use Traefik labels to control routing, and how Traefik will look once we've started it. Traefik is known to have a large learning curve, but by the end of this video, you'll have an understanding of how Traefik works on a basic level and be able to feel confident in configuring it on your server to fully automate handling SSL, routing, and middleware for all your services. What is Traefik? Traefik is a modern reverse proxy and load balancer designed specifically for microservices and Docker environments. We use it for a number of reasons, including automatic service discovery. Traefik dynamically discovers services in your Docker stack using labels. SSL certificate automation. It automatically provisions and renews Let's Encrypt certificates to secure websites and landing pages. Middleware. It can add security headers, rate limiting, and authentication. And the dashboard, where we get real-time metrics and service health through its intuitive web interface. Traefik truly acts as the gatekeeper of our Docker Compose stack, tying together all the services with secure, efficient routing and automation. Without Traefik, none of these services would be accessible or properly secured. This is why it's such a critical piece of our setup. Now let's look at how to set up Traefik. Let's start by checking our root Docker Compose file. We'll include the Traefik service definition from a different file. Notice that Traefik is using a custom network with a subnet. We'll need this to set a static IP for our Traefik container. Next, we'll create the Traefik directory and a Docker Compose file inside it. Copy the contents of all the files from the GitHub repo. Since Traefik handles all of our web traffic, we need to expose ports 80 and 443 for HTTP and HTTPS respectively. Traefik will be in its own network with a static IP address. This must be the same static IP address we use in our uncomplicated firewall rules. If it doesn't match, then UFW will block everything and no traffic will get to this container. If you missed the video where we configured special UFW rules for Docker, hit the card above or check the link in the description. Traefik needs to use the socket proxy to read labels from other services. We'll configure Dyn to notify us when this container needs to be updated. We'll put Traefik on our homepage to link to the Traefik dashboard and have a widget to give us some quick statistics. We'll have CrowdSec read Traefik's logs as part of its live monitoring. We'll cover CrowdSec and its labels in the next video. Notice how Traefik depends on CrowdSec, the CrowdSec bouncer for Traefik, and Authelia. Traefik will use these as middleware, so we want them to be up first. And finally, we'll host the dashboard on the Traefik subdomain. We'll dive further into how these labels work later in this video. Now let's configure Traefik for our server. Configuration in Traefik can refer to two different things. The fully dynamic routing configuration, referred to as the dynamic configuration, and the startup configuration, referred to as the static configuration. Elements of the static configuration set up connections to providers and define the entry points Traefik will listen to, since these elements don't change often. The dynamic configuration contains everything that defines how the requests are handled by our system. This configuration can change and is seamlessly hot reloaded without any request interruption or connection loss. Now let's start with creating the Traefik YAML file, which will serve as the static configuration for Traefik to use at startup. First, we'll enable our dashboard at its insecure endpoint. It is okay for us to use it insecurely because we will be putting it behind our own security middleware with Authelia and CrowdSec. Next, we'll define the entry points. We'll define web to be port 80 and web secure to be port 443. We'll add a permanent redirect so all HTTP requests will be automatically redirected to web secure with HTTPS for greater security. Next, we'll define the providers. This is where we'll give the details for Traefik to use the Docker socket proxy and where our dynamic configuration will be, which in our case will be in the config YAML file. Then we'll define certificates resolvers. Traefik uses these to automatically generate and maintain SSL certificates for our services, which is what enables us to use HTTPS securely. we've defined Let's Encrypt as our default one, and Let's Encrypt Staging for testing. Notice that I put a to-do comment on these email lines. Since Traefik's configuration files don't pull from our environment variables, we'll need to update these emails manually. Replace the example with the email you want to use to get SSL certificates from Let's Encrypt. Also notice how both certificate resolvers need a file to store the SSL certificates to. From my experience, if these files don't exist, Traefik will sometimes create them as folders instead of files, which will cause problems. So once we're done looking at this file, we'll create those files next. Lastly, this file will define how we want Traefik to handle its logging. We'll have its general logs be written to a file. These logs will include details on whether the SSL certificate generation succeeded or not, and other operational logs. We'll have the access logs displayed in the Docker container log. This means they won't be written in files, and this won't be kept long-term. You can technically change this to write to a file if you want, but I've set it this way to make it easier for CrowdSec to read Traefik's access logs for live monitoring. Now let's create the files the certificate resolvers need to use for storage. We'll need one for both our default resolver and our staging resolver. These JSON files should be empty, so we can let the resolvers fill them with the SSL certificates. Now let's define our dynamic configuration with the config YAML file. Since Traefik will do much of its dynamic configuration using labels, we'll just need to define our middleware in this file. Middleware will not automatically be applied to all requests. We'll define it here, but we will tell Traefik which middleware to apply to each service using the labels. First, let's set Athelia to handle authenticating requests. Notice how there is another to-do comment with something for us to change manually. We can't pull the domain from our environment variables, so we'll need to define it manually here. We'll set the CrowdSec bouncer to block malicious activity from known attackers. We'll set up a whitelist of IP addresses to only allow access to requests coming from these. I'd recommend you at least include your local network in the whitelist. You can do this by putting in the static IP address of this server with a prefix of 24 bits. The prefix means it can be any IP address that matches the first 24 bits. In other words, the last number can be anything and still match. This will essentially allow you to mark certain services to be internal to your home network. Of course, if you don't want an IP whitelist, you can simply delete this. We'll want to define a rate limit so our server doesn't get overwhelmed by too many requests at one time. This is a very restrictive rate limit. If you find that it is too restrictive and your server can handle more, you can increase this. We'll get specific on what kind of headers we'll accept. And we'll do the same for API endpoints, since those should allow different methods. And to simplify things, we'll define a number of middleware chains. This enables us to chain a bunch of middleware together in a specific order, and thus reduce how many labels we'll need to use on each service. We'll want a secure chain, which will route the request through the CrowdSec bouncer, rate limiter, secure headers, and Athelia. For those that we want to only access from within our IP whitelist, we'll use a similar chain, but with the IP whitelist applied first. We'll need a no-auth chain for Athelia to use, because if we redirect to Athelia before we can access Athelia, then we'll get stuck in an infinite loop of redirects and not be able to authenticate or access anything. And lastly, we'll define a middleware chain specifically for API requests. Now let's look at how to use Traefik labels. We'll look at our homepage service as an example. First, we need to enable Traefik to work with this service. Then we'll set up routing that will host the homepage service at our domain, using web secure or HTTPS as the entry point, selecting the default certificate resolver, which we've called Let's Encrypt, and giving it the chain secure IP middleware chain, which definition is located in the dynamic configuration file. The last label isn't always required, as it is typically inferred automatically. This tells Traefik what port of this container to send the Traefik to. You can see that it matches with the container port defined above. There are many more Traefik labels, but these are the most common ones you'll be using. Now let's look at Portainer as another example. We enable Traefik, set web secure as our entry point, host it at the Portainer subdomain, set the certificate resolver as Let's Encrypt, the TLS equals true label is inferred if you define the resolver. We set the middleware to be chain secure IP, and add the other optional labels, which we probably don't need to explicitly add, to define the name of the container for Traefik to connect to, and the port to use. Notice how the port is set to 9000. If we look at the top, we see that our portainer is externally accessible by port 9100, and internally accessible by port 9000. Since Traefik is running in the same Docker Compose stack as portainer, we'll be referring to the internal port of portainer. So you can see how these labels are powerful and can even feel simple once you understand them. Let's use Traefik itself as our last example. You can see that it is set up similarly to the other services, but there is one difference. In order for Traefik to host its own dashboard, we'll have to define the service to be API at internal instead of the name of the container. There is so much more about labels that hasn't been covered in this video. To learn more, you can check out the official documentation using the link in the description. If you are still confused about how they work, I'd highly recommend you go through the documentation and experiment with them on your own. We can't really start up our Traefik instance right now because it depends on the other services we haven't set up yet, such as CrowdSec and Athelia. Additionally, Traefik won't work until we've also set the correct DNS records in our domain and set up port forwarding in our router. We'll cover these in a future video. However, when the time comes to start up Traefik, I'd recommend you temporarily change the names of the certificate providers, at least the first startup. This will make it so you will use the staging server to test that all the certificates are properly generated. You'll see error messages in the Traefik log file if they fail. Once you've verified that they work, you can then switch back the names to get the official SSL certificates for your services. Remember that you'll need to restart Traefik every time you make a change to the static configuration in this file. Once Traefik has been started, you'll be able to see it on your homepage, and it should look something like this. If you want to automate the setup of our Docker Compose stack, including Traefik, give Citadel a try. Citadel is my automatic security script that handles everything from network configuration to service setup. It ensures all your files are configured correctly, eliminates typos, and speeds up the deployment process dramatically. Use code Citadel for 20% off your purchase. What unique routing challenges have you solved using Traefik or another reverse proxy? Share your most creative setup in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. In the next video, we'll set up CrowdSec to secure our Docker stack with real-time threat detection. And if you haven't seen our Portainer video yet, click here or check the link in the description. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one.